Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, back again on the German Autobahn, the best place on earth to record videos. Guys, today a totally different topic. I never discussed it before on this channel, and to be honest, I was contemplating if I should discuss it at all. It is a very controversial topic. However, before I start, I want to give you a disclaimer. This video is for my Balkan brothers and sisters, for my Bulgarian brothers and sisters, for my Greek brothers and sisters, for my Serbian brothers and sisters. But more importantly, most importantly, actually, this video is for my North Macedonian brothers and sisters. So, if you don't belong to any of those ethnic groups, I am afraid that this video will be very boring for you. Therefore, feel free to skip this one. Close it down and return again when we come back with other topics. All right, that being said, if you're still here, today we're going to talk about the nationalism, about the nation of North Macedonia, and if I still believe that I am a Macedonian. If you've been following this channel, you know that I identified as a Macedonian Slav. This is what I identified with. However, I wasn't too patriotic about it because I grew up in Germany. I am not too attached to a national identity. Now, that being said, if you follow this channel closely, you know that I have been, first and foremost, a truth seeker. That was the most important thing to me. First, it started out with veganism. I was looking for truth, for dietary truth. But at some point, years down the line, I had to realize that veganism is, plain and simple, wrong. That it is human destruction, and hence I found out about the truth. About the truth of carnivory, about the truth of nutritionally dense animal foods. But the journey didn't end there. The pursuit for truth continued. And I pursued religion. I've been hearing it quite a lot lately. Many people blamed me that I'm not a truth seeker, but that I just returned to Christian Orthodoxy because my parents have been Christian Orthodox. But guys, let me tell you, that couldn't be further from the truth. You have to understand that I was seeking truth. If Islam, Hinduism, Buddhism would have been the truth, I would be the first to convert. I have no shame to admit when I'm wrong. I was always seeking truth, dietary, spiritually. Now, let's talk about the nationality. As I said, growing up, I was told to be Macedonian. Later on, we had to be called North Macedonians. Before that, we were Firum Macedonians. I accepted it, but I never really understood the point of the other side. If you've been following the Macedonian debate, you've seen it before. The Greeks are quick to attack the Macedonians, to tell them they're Fakedonians. They are not real Macedonians, because Macedonia is Greek. And the same goes for the Bulgarians. The Bulgarians would say, hey, you are actually Bulgarians. So there was this debate, there was the discussion, but when you're isolated and you're in your echo chamber, you just listen to your authorities. You never question anything. Again, very similar to veganism, because within veganism, we were listening to the vegan doctors, and everything that the bad carnivores said was wrong. Plain and simple. There was no room for discussion, for debate, for objectivity anymore. We're just listening to our vegan preachers, the vegan doctors. And it was the same with the Macedonian narrative. We were sure to be Macedonian Slavs. Now, to cut the story short, guys, I did my research objectively. I investigated the Greek side, I investigated the Bulgarian side, I investigated the rest of the world, I investigated the Osman archives, the Turkish archives, and I investigated the Macedonian claims. And let's talk about the great Alexander question first. People wondered if Alexander was Greek or if he was Macedonian. The Macedonians claimed Alexander is Macedonian. However, that is a demographic impossibility. Because if you research it, it is very easy to find out who the modern-day Macedonians are. The modern-day Macedonians migrated to that area of the Balkan 6 BC. Alexander, however, died 900 years before. So how can the modern Macedonians be related to Macedonia? It doesn't add up. It doesn't make sense, guys. And I'm talking to you from the heart. I'm talking to my fellow North Macedonians. And as you can see, not even I can accept that name any longer. Because Macedonia was Greece. It is very well established. It is historical truth. Simple as that. So we are not the descendants of Alexander. We are Slavs. Now, if you look further into the history of North Macedonia, you will find many names that turn out to be Bulgarians. Somehow, we as a nation came up with the audacity to critique those forefathers and tell them who we thought they are. Let me give you an example. Tsar Samuel. Tsar Samuel was a Bulgarian. He was so much of a Bulgarian that he actually signed many, many documents as Tsar Samuel the Bulgarian. However, we Macedonians say, you know what? He just thought he is Bulgarian, but in reality, he was Macedonian. You know what? Actually, maybe he was brainwashed. You know what? Probably he just didn't know any better. It doesn't matter that you show the Northern Macedonian people proof and show them that this man truly knew who he was. He was Tsar Samuel the Bulgarian. The same applies to Goce Delchev. Goce Delchev was a Bulgarian. Of course, in the territory of Macedonia, because the name has been kept for a very long time. People knew that this was the region of Macedonia, but that wasn't the national identification. That was simply the region. And that brings me to the Turkish archive, to the Osmanic archive, when the Osmans occupied that particular area, which we now know as Macedonia. The Osmans were very precise about their work, and therefore they counted the people in the demographic and they documented the national identification. So what did we find? In Macedonia, we found over 1 million that identified as Bulgarians. Then we found some Greeks. We found some Turks. We found some Jews. We found some Romas. All of it was found in the demographic of Macedonia. The majority was Bulgarian. So now what is my point? My point, an excuse for the bad lighting here, that's the sun in the background. My point is that there was never a Macedonian Slavic people. The Bulgarians in that area surely identified as Macedonian demographically, but not nationally. Simple as that. And now, how did it come to Macedonia? The naming of it? No, now we're not talking about the ancient empire. We're talking about this modern perception of Macedonia. During the time that the Osmans occupied Macedonia, the Bulgarians created the Internal Revolutionary Macedonian Organization. Yes, as a stance against the Osmans to free that area of Macedonia, demographically Macedonia. So now they united with certain Vlachs, which are Romanians, and they fought the Osmans. The rest is history. This identification, this regional identification, then was taken by Tito, the communist dictator of the Yugoslavian Republic. He was against a Bulgarian identification of that piece of land, and so therefore he started the propaganda against those people. That means everybody that identified as Bulgarian was killed, was persecuted and killed. My great-grandfather was haunted by the Serbs for saying he was Bulgarian. So, why is that important? It is important because the Bulgarians wanted their people back. The Yugoslavs were afraid that over 1 million of Bulgarians would identify with Bulgaria, which wasn't part of the Yugoslavian Republic. On top of that, Tito was a Croatian. And because Tito was a Croatian, he was afraid that the Serbs will gain too much power. And therefore, he didn't want the Macedonians to unite with the Serbs. That would be dangerous, because then Serbia would be more powerful than Croatia. He had to balance it out, and therefore gave those Bulgarian people the identification of Macedonians and infused it with the propaganda of being ancient Macedons, of being a mixture of Slavs, hence Yugoslavia, but the ancient Macedonians as well. So now, guys, to sum it up, who are we as people? Who are we? The North Macedonians? The ancient Macedonians? The Macedonian Slavs? Guys, it is plain and simple. We are Bulgarians. Simple as that. And guys, this message comes from the heart. As I said, I'm sure there will be a tremendous debate in the comment section. On that note, please, no racist comments. Please contain yourself. We're gonna have a civilized discussion. However, this video being for my North Macedonian brothers and sisters. We have to realize who we are. We have to reclaim our heritage. We have to reclaim our national identity. We've been fed communist lies. How long do you want to live with this lie, with this scam? We are not the Macedons. We are not the Macedonians. We are the Bulgarians. I know it's a tough pill to swallow. However, as I said prior, I was a truth seeker. I am a truth seeker. This is me, most importantly. Hey, if the Macedonian truth, the Macedonian side would be true, I would accept it as truth right away. I had no interest in becoming Bulgarian. Why would I? However, it does not matter if the truth hurts. It matters that it is the truth. Think about it, brothers and sisters. I beg you, please, think about it logically. If your partner cheats on you, do you want to live in a fairy tale, in a blissful lie where you don't know about it? Or do you want to know the truth? It doesn't matter if it is soothing. It doesn't matter if it is comforting. We have to wake up and realize who we are as people and reclaim our heritage. We are not Serbs. If you look at the culture of the Serbs, of course, we have around about 10% Serbian population. However, our real customs are Bulgarian. Our national heroes are Bulgarian. And now, let me tell you one more thing. Ljupčo Georgievski, the prime minister of Macedonia, not anymore. I think he stepped back 2001 or 2002. That man is the founder of the right-wing political party, VMRO. He was a neo-Nazi, if you will. He was a Macedonian patriot back then, during Yugoslav times. He was in his 20s. He was rebellious and he founded this right-wing movement. However, around 2000, he couldn't live with it anymore because he researched the field. He is a high-profile politician. Of course, the media puts him into the perspective of a total idiot, of a fraud. Why? Ask yourself why. The man was a high-profile politician. He was invited into the White House. He has seen the world. He has read the books. He has written books. Until he realized that the Macedonian history is fake. It is a scam. It is a lie. It is a psyop created by the Yugoslavs. Ljupčo Georgievski went so far that he couldn't live with this lie anymore, this scam. He had to acquire the Bulgarian citizenship. And now he lives in Bulgaria and writes books in Bulgarian. One book being Facing the Truth. Yes, Facing the Truth. Because guys, let me tell you, you don't have to listen to me. You don't have to take my word as gospel. Please don't. Do your own research, your own independent research, and tell me what you find. Let me know in the comments what you will find. There is no other truth. We are Bulgarians. We are separated brothers. There is no Macedonian identity. It is all Bulgarian. And it is, of course, not Hellenic. It is, of course, not Greek Hellenic. I had talks with the monks and the priests on Athos. It is an embarrassment. It is shameful what the Yugoslavian Republic has done. The brainwashing has to stop. Now Macedonia is facing the challenge of entering the EU. If that is a good or bad thing, that is, of course, a topic for another day. That's not what I'm here to discuss. However, now they're facing again the challenge of discussing their name, their heritage, their language with the Greeks and the Bulgarians. And of course, let's face it, our language is a Bulgarian dialect. If we believe in the story of Kirill and Methodios, then of course we have to accept that those Greek Slavs came to the Bulgarian Empire and taught us the language, the writings. Their disciple, Saint Clement, was Bulgarian. He signed documents as the Bulgarian as well. It was crystal clear that he was identified as a Bulgarian. I know it's a hard pill to swallow, but if you are interested in truth, we have to wake up to this, and it's not too late. The brainwashing has been going on for 100 years, 2 or 3 generations. We can still return to our heritage. We can still return to truth. We cannot keep on going with a fake identity. Who wants to live like this? I beg you, please. I know that many North Macedonians will point the finger at me and say, yeah, man, you grew up in Germany. You have nothing to do with our land, with our national pride. I understand that. Who am I to tell you, right? But let's face it, guys. As I said, I am just the messenger. Don't kill the messenger. Do your own research. And I know how hard it is when the Greeks attack. We tend to shut down when the Bulgarians attack. I get it. I was fighting Bulgarians and Greeks. In the comment section, they were telling me that I'm not Macedonian. And it hurts, right? Because you have this national identity. However, guys, now it comes from a North Macedonian. I haven't seen a video like this on YouTube and understand the ramifications and I understand the danger. However, I have to speak my truth. And this is objective truth. It has nothing to do with subjectivism. This is the objective truth. This is what has happened. This is the history. The whole world knows it. Please wake up. You are the laughing stock of the Balkans with no identity. You're still following the dead leader that brainwashed you. Tito is dead. That ideology has died. We are Bulgarians. We have to reclaim our heritage. I know I'm repeating myself. If we continue like this, we will stay the laughing stock. The Albanians have all the right in the world to attack us. They have all the right in the world. They lived in that area just as long as we did, maybe a little bit shorter. Still, they have all the right to critique Macedonia. There never was such a thing. Don't you understand how vulnerable you are? Once you side with your brothers, the Bulgarians, you will reclaim a heritage that is so rich, so old. I understand the ego games that are being played. The Macedonians only hear it like this. Hey, listen, Tsar Samuel was Bulgarian. Hey, listen, Gotsdelchev was Bulgarian. They feel like you're taking something away from them. But it couldn't be further from the truth, because you are Bulgarian. Simple as that. And because you are Bulgarian, nothing is being taken away from you, but so much is given to you. Alright, guys, this video is long enough. I hope you enjoyed it. As I said, this video is slightly different, actually very, very different. And it is for a particular group of people. Hence, make sure to share it, because this channel is mainly about diet, about spirituality, about God, Christian Orthodoxy. Therefore, make sure to share it with your Greek brothers, with your Bulgarian brothers, with your North Macedonian and Serbian brothers. Make sure to share this video so we can have a sovereign discussion. Yet again, not a racist discussion, no name calling. You can see that a North Macedonian, I would love to have another name. I call myself Bulgarian now. That even a man like me can wake up to the truth. So it is not too late, brothers and sisters. We can still awaken the rest, and we can still reclaim our heritage. All right, guys, but this is it for today's video. Let me know in the comment section what you think. If you like this video, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And guys, as always, may God bless you, much love and peace.